12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Magic Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And first up on this week's show, we have the trick that everybody is talking about. It is Equalizer by Joao, Miranda. And, wow, well, it goes into the crediting, first of all. It's based on something that kind of has been out before, but never this high tech and never this quality. Shahid Malik had the instant radio, and the sound's amazing.
Yeah.
I had both of those.
I liked them. I never did them, though, but I liked them. I had them. I never performed them.
I did used to like the instant radio.
Yeah.
I did used to like picking salt pots up off the table, and turning the salt pots up and starting the recording and that kind, starting the sound waves coming out and the music and then putting the salt pot down. And that was always a nice little moment at events. But this is Equalizer, which is a very small, high-tech device that you can store up to 200 different sound effects on. Three of them are instantly available.
Yeah.
So if you wanted to do an effect like the music box is kind of like the showcased effect, not my preferred effect actually, but it's the showcased effect which is on there. And you could have that set up, you could have the matches, and you could have another sound effect, like the coin effect you liked, didn't you?
I do glass through table at events.
Yes.
Okay? I do that every now and again. And I think this really enhances it. Because if people have, some lay people have seen a children's TV show that teaches us something similar. But if you've got that moment where they are absolutely convinced that the glass is there because they can hear the coin going against the sides of it, and then you grab the spectator's hand and poof, push the whole thing through, what an amazing moment.
It does look great on the tutorial as well. And sound is so deceptive. The actual thing, both of us do like a card under glass style routine where you end up with the whole deck vanishing and becoming one card. And we both got quite excited about that moment where you riffle down and you feel, you hear the cards riffling and then you've only got one card left.
There was a Fizzamax, Shamo or something like that.
No, and that was a whale.
No, so that's Shamu.
Here's your necklace.
And this is my biggest lesson in sound and magic.
Okay.
Was using a manipat with coins. And we knew the sound effects were coming from the track, but having the sound effects of the coins jingling as he was doing the manip, it just took everything to a whole new level. I think he won Fizzum one year.
But just a bit of sound can create an unbelievable effect. Not only do you get the speaker and the actual device which stores everything on, you get an amazing array of tutorials that's all broken down into very short videos, all on one page in Zhao's secret area. And you know, as well as the gimmick being first class and really well constructed, you have to admire the way they've constructed all the trailers and the tutorials. It's very easy to follow. And because you open something like this, and if you've not got those tutorials there, it can be a little bit daunting. You think, crikey, what's all this? But the way he takes you through every single thing, step by step, it's very, very easy to get your head around. Because there are multiple ways to set this up. You can have it in your sleeve, you can have it on your body, you can have it hidden in something which is in view, you know, if you wanted to do that. And you get separate speakers which wire into the main device, one with a shorter lead, one with a longer lead.
It's amazing.
So you can have it down your sleeve or directly coming out of your clothing if you want to. My favourite effect, I know a lot of people must like the music box effect. That's the one that kind of comes with it all set up and ready to go.
I can see myself effect in a Christmas jumper next to the fire doing this to the
Valdunican
family as they sort of, you know, enjoy it. I think
silver
it's great.
Bells,
yeah, it's great.
Bells.
Yeah.
Come on.
And the magic of Christmas, there's nothing even there.
not even Santa. Not even not real.
Santa. not even your dad. He went away years ago.
So So we are going to try and demonstrate. It's the first time we've done it, so we'll try and demonstrate this.
I'm nervous for
it. I'm very nervous about this one. But this is the best trick. In fact, can we have some applause before we start? We managed to find matchboxers in Northampton.
Yeah, it's not going to be easy. I suggest Amazon and not the morning of your performance. It took us seven shops. We've spent longer buying matches for this than we have practicing it.
Yeah, I've been practicing all the time. But I love this. I love this effect. To the moon and back. I love it. Absolutely. It's amazing. So normally a magician, Sean, would get you to pick a card. What I'm going to get you to do is get you to pick a match from this full box of matches. So take it out. Just grab one match. And what I want you to do is memorise that match.
Okay.
Memorise that match. I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll make it easier. I'll get you to sign the match.
It's got an inflection there that I can recognise.
Well, I'll get you to sign it as well. So take the Sharpie and put a little mark on there as well. So now the match is marked.
Got my initials on it.
We are now going to lose that match amongst all the other matches. So that is lost. Hold your hand out, Sean. This is going to be the crazy thing. But put your other hand on top of the matches.
Okay.
This is going to be the crazy thing. Just going to click. And the crazy thing. Every single match in the box completely disappears. Check it out. Apart from one. Just one match. Your signed match. And everything. Yes, amazing.
Amazing! It's got my initials on it. It's definitely my match. I think it's great. I really like it. In the last decade, Jeffrey Durham made a statement where he said, I like doing things where you manipulate liquid because the audience can't understand how you can manipulate it. How do you take that even further? You manipulate sound. Yeah. It can't be done.
It can't be done.
You've put so much preparation into doing this, the audience aren't going to follow it. The audience won't expect that you would have gone to such lengths to make some matches disappear.
No.
And therefore, that's what makes it brilliant.
And depending on where you have the speaker that comes with the Equalizer gimmick, sleeve or body or whatever, it really does. I can't describe to you, when you don't know, it's a subliminal technique that you're using. You really do hear the sound coming from where it's meant to come from.
Oh, you really do. And also, you can use it for, I'm not going to say exactly what it is, but if you know, you'll understand, for cueing audience members as well for certain things.
Yes.
It talks about that on there as well.
Yeah, that's another sort of, to instant stooge spectators, is another very clever use.
Yeah.
Where you're just touching somebody on the head, and they're hearing instructions, secret instructions, that could aid you in mentalism style routines. Mm. I'm not sure I'm going to use it full-time as a gigging magician, but there is no doubt that if you want to add covert sound to your performance, there is no better way of doing this in modern times than Equalizer.
It's brilliant.
The actual gimmick is fantastic, as is everything that comes out of his sort of studio.
It's the best
workshop.
One I've seen. It is the best version of this type of thing that I have seen.
Yeah, I don't have an immediate use for it. I like the matches trick. I love the card, actually. I'm sure I'm going to use it in the future.
The spirit bell as well.
The spirit bell's brilliant. And you can have a bell then. It's not even got a clapper in it, but it's making the noise. It is fantastic. It's a great bit of kit. He hasn't had a bad product for a very long
He's
time.
Not really not.
He used to have a few, but not these days. Not these days. I love this. To the moon and back. There's my quote, Joao. I am going to give it 95%.
I've already got an idea for it, completely out of the box of what it's meant for, so I'm going to do it. I'm going to give this 94%. I think it's brilliant.
It's fantastic. Well done. It's special guest time now on the Wizard Magic Review. We have been joined by James Keatly, an amazing creator. You've had the Black Ops watch and the coining can, which we reviewed on the Wizard Magic Review with Ryan Tricks on the trailer. A great sort of coining can. And today you've come in to talk about probably one of the tricks of Blackpool. Because a lot of people were talking about this after Blackpool, weren't they? This is Big Coin. And tell us a bit about it, first of all, James.
Yeah.
How it all sort of came about.
It's a fun project. It come about through fun. It was an idea that I had prior to Blackpool 2022. And it was an idea that was actually sat on the shelf. I had my first table at Blackpool, and I wanted to take something other than the two products I was demoing, just in case people asked to see something. So I took this with me, showed a few people thinking it was a throwaway idea, and it wasn't. It fooled a lot of magicians. Well, the first move I had at that point fooled a lot of magicians. But showing this at Blackpool was brilliant because I just got so much feedback, so many ideas from other magicians just showing it on the stand. So over the last year, went away and developed, come up with some more moves, linked them together so there was some good routines, showed it to some more magicians, more ideas came, and also managed to change the gimmick from what it was, so it had an extra secret.
Now, I was lucky enough to see it at Blackpool, see it demonstrated. I know Sean's been having a look at the moves today. It does look incredible.
I've had it demonstrated on me. Yeah. It's great. It's really cool. We are
going to do it in a moment. The moment that people see this for the first time, like people did at Blackpool, they're going to want it. It's not available just yet, is it? Do you want to explain what people need to do if they're interested to get it?
So Bitcoin will be launching on the 5th of May on a new magic store called jackmagic.com. That's jakmagic.com. The website is up currently with a sign-in. So if you wanted to be kept up to date with news of the launch and products, you can
And this
sign
is
up.
All your products, not just Bitcoin?
So on launch, it will just be Bitcoin
variations. Okay.
There are two other products planned, but with Jack Magic, it's going to be a slow sort of methodical launch. So nothing within the next 12 months other than Bitcoin.
Right. You have got the bits in front of you right now. Are you happy to demonstrate it to the Wizard Magic Review viewers?
Yeah, let's do it.
And we're going to see this right now. So this is a live demonstration, uncut performance. We're going to see everything.
Yeah. Okay. So before I show Bitcoin, David, have you ever seen the amazing Vanishing Liquid trick?
No.
Okay. So we'll start there because I think you'll notice. Can you do me a favour? Hold your hand out nice and flat like a table. And can you do me a favour? Cover up the glass so the liquid can't escape.
Got it.
Excellent. Now, I'll be honest, David. I don't know how to do a Vanishing Liquid trick.
Right.
But I'm going to show you something cool. Bear with me. I'm going to use this as my wand. There's nothing here.
Yeah.
Nothing here. But if I do this and blow, I can get a coin to appear. It's a magic coin, though. I can easily make it vanish. It goes up in the air, spins around, comes down through the hand, through the glass. It's now in your hand underneath the glass. Lift it up and have a look.
No.
And you can check it out. That's sure, cool. It is actually a genuine coin.
That is a genuine coin.
But we can do it visibly so you can actually see the magic happen. If I take the coin, look, there's nothing else here. Just watch this spot. And we can get the coin to jump through the table. It's like, okay, it is actually a genuine coin.
I like that.
Unbelievable.
That's about as eye-popping as it gets.
I'll let everyone in on the secret. It's a gaff coin. If you press here and give it a little rub.
Oh, wow. Come on.
Bitcoin.
That is eye-popping magic from start to finish. The big surprise when the coin appears in your hand under the glass. You're not expecting that. My favourite is when it comes through the table.
Well, that's...
That's
the money shot.
That is
it?
The money shot.
And do you get everything with it?
Yeah.
Do you get the big coin, all the gimmicks?
So I can open a box. I won't show everything.
No, we don't do that on our show.
There is a jumbo coin included.
Yeah.
The jumbo coins are really nice. They're brass-coated jumbo coins.
That is lovely.
And they're 70 mil.
Well, they make a really nice... Some of them sound tinny when they drop. If you bang the table with that, that's a, That's a solid coin.
And it's not too big. It's a bit smaller, isn't
70
it?
70 mil.
Because the one I used to use in my circle to the fourth dimension routine, that was a bit bigger. But yeah, that's a much better angle for even for that. It's like a whole act.
Do you know when I got into magic? Yeah. You know, you heard me say this so many times. Yeah. The kids nowadays have forgotten this, right? I was like, I need 6 to 8 minute routines so when I'm a grown up, I can do magic at tables and it looks like I'm doing actual routines. This is the stuff.
Yeah.
It teaches you. There's nothing that a beginner magician can't do, I don't think, with a little bit of practice. And it's a proper routine. It's eye-popping. You're going to, if you are doing restaurant magic and stuff, people are going to be convinced that you are a master of sleight of hand from learning this routine. And it's a proper routine. You look like a pro doing it.
Yeah, the gimmicks are first class as well. Everything that you get with it, the level of teaching. Obviously, I remember you, James, the year you gave us at Blackpool coin in can to review.
Yeah.
And we came away and reviewed it a couple of months later, because it takes a while for things to appear on the Wizard Magic Review. You were playing with this idea then.
Yes.
So that was, you probably had this idea 2-3 years ago, and you've only just started to bring it out.
Yes. Yeah, it, as I said, after Blackpool, that really, it was actually the kind words from Jeff Price and from Wayne that actually sort of pushed this for me to develop.
Yeah, I know Wayne absolutely loves this and has been playing with it since Blackpool. It's an amazing gimmick and it's a great routine. And the way it's all structured and comes together, and you've got the finale as well. It's not just, so many people these days, magic dealers, magic producers, creators, they just have this bit, the coin, and they go, that's it, a coin comes through the table. What I like about it is that you've taken it further. It is a whole little act in itself that suits close-up, parlour. It's,
and you don't have to do the
fantastic
whole thing. You
everyday
don't,
carry
you
stuff.
You can pick bits of it as well. You don't have to do the full routine if you wanted to add that bit into a, whatever you want to do.
The tuition, and I must do a shout out here because at the Session Magic Convention, Lloyd took me over to introduce me to Craig. Craig Petty, for those who obviously I think everyone would know.
Anyway. I think we know.
And Craig offered to shoot and film the tutorial.
Yeah.
For free, really helped me out, really turned the tutorial into a very professional product, and a big shout out to Nemid as well, Nemid Phoenix, who actually did the film.
Yeah, those guys are so creative. I don't know how they do it, just create so many ideas and routines.
It was the additional ideas, but what Craig also did is the interview style way of doing the tutorial really helped with my nerves, helped me get the information across. But it also, we taught it modularly. So each individual phase and move is taught individually, and then you're shown how you can put them together to create different routines. As well as that, on the tutorial, there's a whole section of further ideas and utility moves and routine ideas from the likes of Craig, Elliot Gerard, Lloyd Barnes, Harry Harrington, and Chris James.
That's amazing.
And the more people I show this to, the more and more ideas that people come up with. So we definitely will be doing a Facebook group for this product, so people can get involved, share more ideas, and as new ideas come in, the tutorials are on Vimeo. It's a showcase, so we'll be adding in more tutorials. So Lord Harry just provided me with a tutorial for a one-handed loading of the gimmick, which is just amazing. Really opens up.
It's a great project. It's available from May the 5th.
Yeah.
You need to register at the website if you want to make sure that you get one from the first batch when the new gimmicks are made. What's the website again? Just say it again.
It's jackmagic.com. That's jakmagic.com.
It really is brilliant. And come on, you've got to give them a teaser of what might be coming out next. Not necessarily with this.
Yeah.
You can say as little or as much as you like, but okay. I know you've always got amazing ideas and different things and that kind. You don't have to say a full thing. You could just say one word that just teases people. What might be out at Blackpool 24, for example?
So two things. So from Jack Magic, there will be something similar to Bitcoin, but not coins.
Okay.
Right.
And not a lighter.
Right. Okay.
It's similar in project. So
that's something you're developing.
Involves candy. That's what I can say.
I like candy.
And then the one other thing, I do have a product that's in the works with Illusionist as well, which is probably my favourite thing I've ever created. It's very simple, very understated, very bold.
And when's that out? You say in the works?
It's in the works. So yeah. It's made, it's packaged, with just tutorials to film.
So next few
that's
months,
soon
maybe.
Soon then,
hopefully,
very soon.
Again, I don't know with that one.
What type of trick? Close-up mentalism?
Oh, close-up. Close-up with some mentalism aspects that could actually be combined.
Right, well,
very, very different. So.
And before, I've got to give credit to the... Any name that's got a pun in it, I like it. But so, no, we've not talked about it. Bitcoin. I mean, that's a round of applause for me. I'm right. I'm there already. I'm there.
I didn't even get it until Bitcoin. You said that. Yeah, of course. Bit lighter. There we go. James, thank you for coming in. You are an amazing creator of magic. I love this routine. I love that it's a full routine. And I'm going to go onto the website. The website is on the bottom of the screen. Make sure you go on and register to keep an eye on all James's creations for the future. James Keatly on the Wizard Magic Review.
Thanks for having me, guys.
Before we do our final review, I want to do a huge thank you to Leicester Magic Circle. Oh. I lectured for them last week, and it was a great crowd. There are lots of top magicians, actually, at Leicester Magic Circle, and Wayne Dobson used to go there many years ago, and Roy Johnson.
Yeah, I remember a cabaret act called Tony Ricks that was on
Tony
the circuit.
Tony Ricks was there,
and he was there.
It was amazing. There were lots of top professionals in the
audience.
A
professor was there.
Yes, Clive, the professor, and it was amazing. Thank you so much. I got a genuine. I had people messaging me going, "That's not real. That standing ovation." No, what happened? Was I got a standing ovation genuinely for my lecture, and I said, don't sit down, let me film it. Because if you don't film it and put it on Facebook, it didn't happen. But yeah, not for the first time, which is amazing, I got a standing ovation for my lecture, and I really enjoyed lecturing for the Leicester Magic Circle. I know Middlesbrough is coming up, I've got another couple of lectures. But if you would like a lecture and you're in the UK or fancy flying me somewhere exotic, I can do that as well. But I'm really enjoying lecturing at the moment. I've got a new bit in the lecture all about creativity and showing some new ideas as well. And I really enjoyed it. So thank you very much, Leicester Magic Circle, for having me, and get in touch if you'd like a lecture for your club. Finally this week, we have The Last Rise by Andrew.
The amazing Andrew.
The amazing
what
Andrew.
What showbiz name?
That is the
Andrew.
Name. That's the creator's name. How,
but which Andrew is it? Is it Andrew Murray? Is it Andrew Eborn? Who knows? It's just Andrew.
Brought out this effect by Magic Dream, Paris, France. We picked this up at Blackpool. We've got a few amazing items coming up from Magic Dream as well that are going to make their way onto the Wizard Magic Review table. This is a card trick, so Sean was very interested in this. I know he loves this plot and has been looking for a practical version for a long time. So,
is this it?
Can you do it?
Dave, I'm going to show you something with these cards. Yeah. What I want you to do is remember a red card and a black card for me.
Okay.
You are going to play two spectators, Jekyll and Hyde.
Right.
We're going to call this the bipolar card trick. Have you got a red card and a black card, Dave?
Oh, show me. Yes, red
and black. So you're spectator A and spectator B today. Now we're going to seal the cards and in the box, or place them in the box, to sleight of hand proof them from me. And you can see there's no way in or out of the box, okay?
There's no
they
way.
They really are sealed
I'm
in this box.
I'm just trying to remember my cards.
Yeah, remember your card. And I'm going to do the black one first, Dave.
Okay.
So I need to remember the black card.
Do you want me to say it?
Just say it for me now.
Six of spades.
Keep saying six of spades. Keep singing six of spades.
And
then one
six
card rises out of the pack. Now have a look, Dave. That really is. Only six of spades. Dave, very quickly, then the second card.
Very quickly. The nine of hearts. Oh!
The nine of hearts, ladies and gentlemen. And it really is like real magic.
It looks fantastic. Right, some things that completely blew me away about that when we were watching the performance by Andrew on the trailer. The cards come out of the box.
Yeah,
he was showing the box, and I was like, "Hang on a minute, what are you doing? You've got a full deck there."
We did that thing where we didn't read the instructions.
Yeah, we never do. We never do that, Sean.
We watched the trailer. We went, "Oh, let's give it here," and then we went.
Better not take it out.
They're taking them out. I thought, oh, it's going to be all them things where he's made a fake trailer. It's going to be annoying. And then we watched the instructions.
And he said uncut performance. And we're like, hang on.
What? An uncut performance? He took him out of the box, Dave. He took him out of the box. And then he did the trick. And we both went, wow. Then we watched the instructions. And we went, oh. Then we're like,
we don't normally do that if you're a creator.
Does it work every time?
Yes, it works every single time.
Can a beginner do it?
Let's talk, you know, the original. When I was a kid, I had the Divano writing cards. You were forever going like this. And it was a bit given. It was an amazing gimmick, but it was half the deck, the gimmick. And it was incredible for its time. I remember saving up to buy one for about 30, 40 quid when I was a kid.
Not out of my budget.
And it is an amazing thing, the Divano rising cards. But it didn't always work. This, every single time the card comes out. In fact, it's so precision, the way the card comes out, it allows you to do that second move, which just looks unbelievable, where the card just changes. So it's like the card rising, then changes to the other card.
Oh, it's brilliant. I really like
this. If you wanted to, you could remove the card.
Now, there's the other version that I know I've done on filming things, where you have to release the pressure of the deck. I think Blaine's done that one on TV.
Anthony Owen used to do that in his lecture.
Jeff McBride, I think. I think even that, sometimes you're not completely in control of
sometimes it
jumps up and something, you know. This, you're in complete control. You can do it twice. The gimmick's very, very clever.
Let's be honest about angles, just for a moment. That's probably the only negative with it, isn't it? It's not, you need your audience pretty much in the front. You know, sort of 45 degrees in the front.
Yeah, not quite 45 degrees.
They are going to notice something. So the others that you mentioned are angle-proof. This is not totally angle-proof.
No, not totally.
It's not.
I wouldn't be.
Can't do it if people stood behind you.
You definitely can't.
Or the immediate.
You can't. Yeah, you're definitely right there. But it is very good.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm doing it. Dave's already sold. If it's got any, I'm going to have it.
No, well, we don't sell items.
But I'm going to have one.
You can get it from Magic Dream.
I'll go to Magic Dream. Dot whatever and buying it.
How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give it 99%. I love it. I actually love it.
I'm never going to do it, but I do. No, I do like
it. I'm
going to give it exactly 89% because I do think. Look, one thing I am sort of blown away by is the quality of the gimmick.
Yeah.
It is really well made. They do say, and it's true, every single one of the gimmicks is completely handmade. You couldn't make this yourself. It's unbelievable.
It's phenomenal.
It's so well made. Just the fact that you can show the card case all around and then the card rises out. There is so much deception going on here that allows you to do a trick that is pretty much self-working.
It is really. There's not really anything going on. And in real world environment, what you need to get away with is going to be very easy.
Yeah, if you're doing magic normally and you can handle a deck of cards and you can get through a performance, you're picking this up and you're doing it in 5 minutes.
Yes.
Once you've watched the tutorial.
I've proven.
Once you've watched the tutorial.
Yeah.
Congratulations. Andrew has come up with a real world working method for the rising card, and he's got that kicker of the change as well. So it's absolutely brilliant. We've had some great items on this week's show, The Last Rise. We will have more items from Magic Dream coming onto the show very, very soon. We have the Equalizer by Joao Miranda, probably the product that everybody's talking about. This week, like I say, I love that to the moon.
Yeah.
That is amazing.
Brilliant.
And thanks to James Keatly for coming in and talking to us about Bitcoin. That moment where the coin just materializes under the lighter.
It's brilliant.
Probably the best bit of visual magic that was sold at Blackpool this year. Absolutely fantastic. It's been a great week this week. Lots of great items on the Wizard Magic Review. Lots more to come. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time, I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
We'll see you next time on the Wizard Magic Review.